my channel. I am coming at you with another Poshmark video. I just went to PlATOS Closet, which is where I shop for most of my inventory for my Poshmark closet. So I thought I would show you guys what items I picked up, what I purchased them for, and what I plan to list them for in my closet. So I talked about in my last Poshmark video kind of the expectation I have when purchasing items as far as profit margins go and what I want to make on an item before purchasing it. So I'll kind of go through my strategy for purchasing items and again, what I'm listing them for and everything like that. So I'm excited. I feel like this will be super fun. Obviously, if you go to a resale shop, you're not gonna be able to find the same items. But again, this is kind of just to show you my strategy, what items I pick up and why, and talk a little bit more about pricing and stuff like that. So let's get into it. Okay. So the first item that I purchased was this Lululemon jacket. This is more of like a fall type jacket. It's a little heftier. It's kind of like that swishy type material. I don't actually know the style name of this jacket, but it's in pretty much perfect condition. And it's just a very good basic thing that I feel like a lot of people could get use out of. And of course it's Lululemon, so it will sell. And something to note is at PlATOS Closet, I don't know if it's different in different states, but they have like a reward point system. And so once you spend a certain amount, you get 20% off your purchase. And every time I go into PlATOS Closet, I spend enough to where I get that 20%. So pretty much every single time I shop at PlATOS Closet, I know when I'm looking at the price tags that I'm gonna get 20% off because I always have that offer valid. So keep that in mind. So this was marked at $45, which my PlATOS Closet's really weird. Sometimes I'll find jackets for $25 or $30, and then other times they list them for $45. I don't even know if they have their own system or if it's different girls listing the prices, but sometimes I'll find clothes and I'm like, I'm not even buying that because this is listed way too high, and I just bought the same item basically a month ago for half the price, so it's weird. But regardless, this was listed at $45, so with my 20% off, that comes to about $38 or $39. And this jacket is probably originally $128 because this is heftier and more of like an actual jacket than just like the Define workout jacket. So since this was originally $128 and it is in perfect condition, I'm probably gonna list this jacket at $99. And I can't remember if I talked about this in my last video or not, but I always list things obviously higher than I'm willing to sell them for, so that I can leave room for people to send me an offer. I can leave room for people to bundle and give them a discount on that bundle. I always leave room to send offers to likers. That is probably the number one way that I make sales. So when you send an offer to likers, anybody who has liked that item, you have to leave enough room to give them the discount because the minimum discount has to be 20%. So you have to be willing to go down that much and still make the profit. I don't know if that makes sense, but basically, I know that I can list this for $99. I probably won't sell it for $99 unless someone sees it and just boom, purchases it. But realistically, that probably won't happen. But since I spent $39 on this, if I make $59 or $69 profit and I profit $20 or $30 on this jacket, then that makes it totally worth it. So that's the first item. So then the next item I purchased was this Lululemon tank. This is the, what is this called? Swiftly Tech, yeah, the Swiftly Tech tank top. And this is also in perfect condition and it was marked at $18, so I get it for $15 with my discount. And the original cost of this shirt is $58. I will probably list it for $45 or $50 because again, it is in perfect condition. So this was definitely a good find. I only ever buy Lulu tank tops if they are listed at $18 or below. That's just my personal preference because people aren't gonna spend the same amount in your closet as they are at the actual store brand new with the tags. So, but with Lululemon, you also have to keep in mind, they don't have sales very often. They do have sales, they always have their sales rack, but it's very small and there's a very limited amount in each size. So people realize that getting a discount on Lululemon items that they specifically want is rare. So even if they're only getting $5, $10, or $15 off of a Lululemon item, they will still purchase it from your closet because it's the only way for them to get that discount. And especially if the item is in basically perfect condition or perfect condition. So that's that. And then I got this long sleeve Lululemon shirt. It's just like a slouchy, thin, gray long sleeve shirt. And I purchased this for $18 as well, which is a really good price for a long sleeve shirt. Because this is the same price, obviously, as the tank top that I just showed you guys. The original price of this, since it's a long sleeve from Lulu, was probably $78. So I will probably list this at $65. So a lot of people say, like when I tell them what I list items at, that they feel like it's really high. Because I always tell people, when you're listing items in your closet, list higher than you would think. Because again, it's going to give you room to negotiate. It's going to give you room to send offers to likers. Like, you need that wiggle room with the person that's interested in your item. And, you know, as long as you're not listing something for more expensive than it actually is for brand new, then who cares? If you don't get that much for it, you don't get that much, but at least you tried to get the most on that item that you possibly could. So next is another Lululemon hooded jacket. Actually, it's like a, what is that? Like a quarter zip jacket with a hood. And this was actually listed at $50, which is very expensive, but again, with my discount, this came up to $40, and this is probably a $168 jacket, so I will probably list this at $125, but I do need to check to see if I can find this jacket and find the actual price of it. And then next is another tank. This one is also in perfect condition. It's got the little like hole, not hole, but like little sliver thing in the back. And this was, oh wow, $22. I feel like I accidentally purchased this. Normally I would not purchase a tank top for $22. I get it for $19 with my discount, but still, that's kind of a lot for a tank. But again, I will probably list this between $45 and $50. Next, another Lululemon item. This is their, I think, is this the energy bra? I think this is called the energy bra. It's super bright white, so you can tell that this was either never worn or maybe worn like once. This is in absolute perfect condition. And this was $18, so I got it for $15. This is originally a $58 bra, so I will again probably list this at $45 or $50 to start. Oh, that just fell on the floor. Next is another tank. This one's really cute. It's like a sheer, kind of like dotted fabric. And this also looks brand new because of how white it is. And this I purchased, again, for $22. Dude, what's wrong with me? I don't remember doing that, but that's okay. So I won't make as much as normal on these tank tops, but I'll still be able to profit. So it's not like a loss or anything. But yeah, I'll probably list this one for $50, even though it was probably only originally $58. Because I think this is a rare item. I shop at Lululemon all the time and I have not seen this in there. So that's a good thing too about like Lululemon or really any brand. If they have items that are sold out or no longer sold, you can a lot of times list them for either the same price as what they were originally marked at, or even higher in some cases if it's something that's in really high demand and there's no way for people to purchase that item anymore. Okay, so the next thing that I purchased were these leggings that are, again, Lululemon. They look like they are in perfect condition. And these, where is the tag? That's really weird. Well, okay, now I need to go back and look at the receipt because now I don't even know what I paid for these. But I'm pretty sure I paid $30 because most of the time, unless it's a rare style or like the Aligns or something, I will not pay more than $30 for leggings. And if these were $30, then with my discount they were $25. Since they are in perfect condition and they are black and they are a color that a lot of people would want, I will probably list these at $85. Next is another pair of leggings. These are the Zone In tights. These I got a great deal on. They were marked at $24, so I probably actually am only gonna pay like $20. Yeah, and these are literally in perfect condition. High-waisted, so people are still wearing them. If I find like non-high-waisted Lulu leggings, most of the time I won't purchase them because most people just aren't wearing leggings that aren't high-waisted. But there is exception always. But anyways, this was an amazing deal because like I said, I got these for $20 and I will probably list them for $80. Oh, this, I just thought it was cute, to be honest. So this is from PacSun, and it's still new with the tags. And it's just like a little bralette, but it's like a creamsicle color. I don't know, I just, so every once in a while when I see an item that I just think is cute or just think it will sell for whatever reason, I'll pick it up even if it's not athletic wear or like a super popular brand. So just depends, but I don't know. I just like that and it was cheap, very cheap, $8. So like $6 with my discount. These were an awesome find. So more Lululemon leggings. These are also high-waisted camel print, which is super in right now and literally perfect condition. They look like they've never been worn. These were listed at 40, but like I said, I will spend more than 30 on leggings if I feel like they're a style that's really popular. And since camo is really in and they are in perfect condition and they are high-waisted, I decided to purchase them. And so with my discount and everything, I will pay like 35 and I will probably honestly list these for 100 because I don't think these are available any longer, and again, they're basically like new. Okay, another pair of leggings, which these ones are actually only mid-rise. These aren't high-waisted, but I thought the print was super cute, and it's something that would like match a lot of things, so I think a lot of people would still really like these. And these are also in absolutely perfect condition. These were also listed at 40, so 35 with my discount, and I will probably list them for 90. Somewhere like that. Oh, next, a non-Lululemon item, a Nike jacket, which is super cute. It's perfect condition, very bright white, so you can tell when people don't wear them a lot when they look like they are like glowing white. This I bought for 14, so basically 11 or 12 with my discount. I will probably list this for 60 or 70 bucks because I bet originally this was probably 90 or 100. I will look into it. Okay, the last item I found today was another Lululemon jacket. Really, really good condition. It's like a thicker jacket. I actually don't know the style of this. I'm gonna have to try to look it up. And this I purchased for 45, which again is kind of a lot, but I felt like it was in really good condition. And with the season of winter coming, people are gonna be wanting jackets. And I still know that I can make 20 or 30 or 40 bucks on this, so I will probably list this for close to 100. So when I am listing items, I told you guys in my last video that my goal is always to double my money on each individual piece of clothing. However, if it is something that I spent $40 or $50 on, I'm most likely not gonna double my money because people could just go to Lululemon and purchase it brand new at the price of me doubling my money. So if I see an item and I know that I could make $20, $30, $40 and above on that item, even if I don't double my money, to me that's still totally worth it. I just won't waste my time buying, you know, spending $8 or $10 on a shirt and then making $3, $4, $5 on it. I just simply don't think it's worth the time to list and package it up and do all of that. That's obviously completely up to you, but just me personally, I just like to make a little bit more on each item so I don't have to worry about selling a million little items every single day. I just have to sell a few bigger items or bundles, and then I will make, you know, anywhere between $50 and $200 in a day on Poshmark in profits. So that is pretty much that. And if you guys have any questions regarding Poshmark whatsoever, leave them in the comments. I will definitely get back to you. I also have my free top seller guide, which you guys can check out. That I created a few months back. And then I also have a full ebook that you can check out as well regarding Poshmark and how to go full time and how to make a full blown business out of it. So with that, I hope you guys enjoyed and thank you as always for your support. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up button to help support my channel and subscribe so you don't miss future videos. And I will see you guys in the next one.